Hey guys, this is David Kwan here, continuing to talk about gay marriage, the debate, and the arguments that the opponents of gay marriage bring up. I think this video is going to tackle an argument that I have the most difficulty kind of countering against. I find it to be the most logical argument, and I feel like this argument is not going to be used by the right-wing religious people at all, because it's a conservative libertarian argument. It values states' rights. So this, you know, let's say that it's a libertarian arguing this. This libertarian, you know, the recent Supreme Court cases, Prop 8, he would probably support. But something like DOMA, he would not support. So I don't see any religious person having this argument just because it leaves room for something like DOMA to become unconstitutional. A person viewing homosexuality as a sin would not use this argument because they wouldn't win with this argument. But a libertarian would use this argument. And that's that marriage should be left up to the states. The federal government should have no say in it. Traditionally, in American history, it's true. Marriage has been something that's usually been left up to the states. Even now, every state has different definitions of marriage, different laws, different legal definition of marriage. Every state does. I respect that. I think that's totally okay, actually, because each state has different circumstances, different kinds of people living in it, that it makes completely total sense. So they would be against DOMA because Defense of Marriage Act says that the federal government does not recognize gay marriage as a legal concept. You know, it does not legally recognize gay marriage. Libertarian would say, yeah, that's unconstitutional, because federal government should not have a say in that. That's a private matter. Marriage is something that's between, you know, families and between states and local governments. Federal government should not have a say. So, in a Supreme Court case like Windsor v. United States, where Edith Windsor is arguing that, you know, United States should not be making gay marriage illegal across the country, this libertarian having this argument would be on the side of Edith Windsor. But they would be against gay marriage advocates because gay marriage rights people raising up or promoting or campaigning for ROMA, Respect the Marriage Act, which is the exact opposite of DOMA, which says, you know, federal government legally recognizes gay marriage. The libertarian in this argument say would be like, no, that's unconstitutional. It should be left to the states. Which is about it. Like, it's an interesting point. But I feel like marriage is not a right. I don't know. It can be argued, maybe. But I'm on the side that marriage can't be considered as a right, per se. It's not a fundamental right that everyone should have. But here's the thing. With marriage comes so many fundamental rights. 1,100 rights. A lot of them are trivial, but a great deal of them are fundamental, are really important. If you deny marriage to a certain group of people, you are denying that group those certain rights. Currently, libertarian would agree that certain protections, he wouldn't agree, I don't know. But there are certain protections. A state, for example, right now can't just say a marriage between a black man and a white man is illegal. No state can do that. No matter how much you value states' rights, no state can say that right now. They can't say a Catholic marrying a Jew is illegal. No state can do that right now because it's a federally protected class. Gay people, lesbian people, transgender people, bisexual people, and any other kind of considered queer people are not in that protection. I think they should be. And that protection overrides states' rights. Yes, states' rights are violated because of that protection. But those people's rights are violated if states' rights are upheld. And I think that's fundamental. I think gay groups, you know, LGBT community should totally be included in the federally protected class. And if that's the case, we need to have legislation like ROMA, Respect the Marriage Act. We need a federal law recognizing gay marriage as something that's totally legal in order so that this whole entire group is not discriminated against. If, for example, Alabama decides that, you know, hey, we don't we think a marriage should be between, you know, it shouldn't be between a white person and an Asian person. Just, I don't know, just randomly saying. The federal government is going to step in and say, no, they're a federally protected class. Race is not something that you can categorize, redefine marriage on, like, in that manner. And so states' rights would be by, like, Alabama would not have the right to do that. But the Asian people and the white people would have the right to marry. And I think that should be how it is. And it should be the same thing for gay people. So that's my counter argument to the libertarian argument that it should be left to the states.